Now, it used to be called it's like Smart Home Solutions, but we kind of like wanted to get away from the smart home shit because we was doing restaurants and stores and, you know, all kind of shit. And, you know, you the nigga tell you, like, yeah, I got an Amazon Echo, I got a smart house. And you like, all right. You know, it's such a new industry, niggas don't understand what it is for real.
So that's your, how did you get into that type of shit?
Just like, so I started like putting TVs up. It's on like 2010, like we just did a joint in the house. Then I'm like, I was always like a hustler, so I'm gonna figure out how to make some money with this shit. So I just started putting people's TVs up. Then like 3 years after that, I got into the electrical apprenticeship, like the union joint. Boom, did that shit for 5 years. Graduated that bitch on like a Friday, quit on Monday. But I was doing side work the whole time.
Oh.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like,
so you graduated Friday, quit Monday.
And then I've been rolling ever since.
Just solo?
Me and my son. You graduated high school in what, 2018? 19.
So you never gonna have to get a job. That's what we bring into the black market, man. We trying to get people to start owning businesses.
Yeah.
Welcome back to the black market. Look, man, I told you, my research department be on it, bro. Is this you?
That's impressive, man.
This you?
That's me.
You sure?
Man.
Because this look like you about to be, it look like you an unsigned rapper on this bitch.
I used to be, man. back in my younger days, man.
Jamil Gibbs.
Yeah.
My man. From Logix Design Bill. But you said it used to be called what?
Usually go by Smart Home Solutions.
Nah, man.
That shit wasn't funky, right?
That ain't it. That sound like something wrong with the house.
You feel like you just do anything.
Like solution? What you mean?
I just got a solution for you.
Nah, man, but hey, my dog right here cold as hell, man. With all anything electrical, smart, he know how to hook up Alexa through your shower. Man, this dude cold as hell, and it's just like, his story is so amazing, we had to bring him to the black market, because I know you might be a business owner, you might be a homeowner, you may have been looking for the services and the type of knowledge that he has. Him and his son apparently have just been all over America just hooking up electronics for rich white people and shit. Bro, introduce yourself properly, man, because you know I'm scrambling. I just ate. I'm high a little bit.
There's a lot going on.
I might have to pull in a minute. I don't know. This is a black-ass show, man. Get him a rundown of who we talking to today.
So I don't know where I'm at, but my name's Jamil.
Jamil.
My company now is called Logix Design Build.
That's exactly how a black man who own a whole business would introduce himself. Hey, what's up, man? My name's Jamil. I run my own shit.
That's all it is.
Black
right?
market.
That's all it is. I ain't got nothing funky. But no, so I started putting up TVs probably like in 2010. I think maybe with my own one, and then, you know, me always being just a natural hustler, it's like, if I can do it and I enjoy it, let me see if I can make some money from it and we'll see where it go.
So hold on, you just sitting at the crib and it's like, I can hang that shit up myself.
Yeah.
No prior practice or nothing, it's just
YouTube. Back then it was like two YouTube, because you know, I'm 37. So okay. I didn't come up in the, we ain't had that shit, we had a dictionary. You know what I mean? Like that was it. So when you get on YouTube, like it was just so amazing to see a platform where you could learn to do so much from the comfort of your own home.
Right.
And all I need to experiment is what, a TV and a couple dollars to get a mount. So like, yeah, let me see. And from there, I think I got into the technical aspect more, like, all right, how can I take it to the next step? And at the time, I'm working in like, believe it or not, like I'm working in the courthouse as like a court clerk or some shit, like running files back and forth.
Some bullshit.
You know, selling like 30, 40,000 a year. And it hit that time, like, my son now, who's 20 now, he was probably like, shit, I don't know. Is that like 2008?
About 10.
About, yeah, something like that.
See, I know how old your son is.
Yeah, we both must be high, because that's way off. That's way off. But nah, so, you know, he was younger. I had to make a decision. You know, you hit that wall, like, am I going to do this corporate shit forever? Am I going to do something, you know, bigger? So I knew
corporate looked good when you ain't working corporate.
That shit was.
Because it looked like you about to go over there and make some money.
Yeah,
and then you get over there, you like,
hey, listen,
I'm spending most of my money on these goddamn shoes.
You dressed up first thing in the morning to go and get coffee and shit like you a lawyer or something.
Can you make you feel good.
Courthouse, I'm making $12.75 an hour.
Exactly, for some motherfuckers who making $200 this week.
You feel me? So that never lined up with me. You know what I'm saying? I don't even think I really
the motherfuckers
had
who getting all the bread ain't even doing shit.
Nah, they telling you what to do, but I respected that. Like, I was never the one to be like, nah, I'm mad, you know, they making money. It's like, how do I get in that position? Because if they can do it, I can do it too. And, you know, that was the attitude, so.
That's still my attitude.
Yeah, you now, cause now you've been doing this so long, you spoil. I can't work for nobody else. I tried to get a job when the pandemic first hit. You know, everybody was scared. They ain't know.
The last time you needed one.
The last time, right? But I had like probably like 20,000 in projects. Boom, disappeared as soon as the shit hit. So I'm, you know, family, kids. I went to a job one day. It was like a 5-month contract. Like one day. I'm in there, you know, white dude coming there, he all, you know, smelling like cigarettes, spitting and shit, you know, and I'm seeing every reason I left this shit 2 years ago, you know, in play. I might last like 6 hours, then I'm out, you know, back to it. But it was like a little refresher, you know, like, yeah, you sure this what you want?
Bro, I'll be having nightmares about getting a job.
Yeah.
Real.
And it's not to knock anybody that got a job, but at the same time,
now,
it's
all
like,
jobs ain't bad. It's some good ass jobs out there. Yeah. I'm just saying this. Oh, fuck that.
It's just in some people, like, it's like a natural fuck the system thing where I can't, if I could provide for myself, I can't ask anybody. You know what I mean? Because I can't be on their time.
Right.
And they, you know, they call.
Especially like when they got somebody who dumber than you trying to tell you what to do and shit.
The case at what? 90% of jobs? 98.
Don't nobody really know shit.
You know? So everybody going through the motions. And that's right. That wasn't ever what I was trying to do. You know, I always felt like it was something bigger that we could do. And even when we was in the union, I mean, that's a $100,000 job, you know, in Maryland. You need that damn near to live comfortably up there, but
right.
It's not bad money. So, but I seen the ceiling the same thing in 5 years, as soon as we graduated, it's like, nope, can't do this. Even if even $400,000 costs too much.
Right.
And we just kept grinding with it. So the whole time I was in the apprenticeship, I was doing side work. Fuck it now. You know, I ain't there no more. You ain't supposed to do that shit. But
people need shit.
They need shit. You know, they're gonna ask you how you put the chandelier up for me. Yeah, I am.
Yeah.
So we had that clientele through the whole 5 years, and I managed, and I probably put my son into it when he was like 10. And he would go, he ain't really care about it back then, you know what I'm saying? It was like, you know,
it was some shit for him to do.
Yeah, something.
You wouldn't let him do like electrical work.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. And then once he graduated high school, you know, I kind of pushed him to figure out, you know, where he wanted to go, you know, if he wanted to, you know, do the job thing in school but just let him know, like reassured him, like, but if you need some time to figure it out, we got something going on here that could provide.
In the meantime.
You know, in the meantime.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But when as a father, ain't that dope though that your son would even want to be, you know, in the family business.
It's
you know, a lot of people shy away from.
Yeah.
You know, I want to do my own thing.
Yeah, it's the best part of it, and it's because it wasn't forced. Like, we know it wasn't, no matter, you know, most people say, oh, the son work for the business. It's like nothing was
right.
Forced,
right,
and, you
right.
know, and the moment.
And he do understand that one day that he going to have to take over.
Yeah, I mean, even.
Building a legacy.
Even, so this is the thing, this is how we look at business, right? And I get this from studying, you know, again, YouTube and these different, you know, people and their experiences. You're supposed to build a business with an exit strategy anyway. Cause really nobody, I don't want to fucking work at all. To be honest, like in the next 3 years, I want to be on the fucking beach answering calls. Like, yeah, okay, cool. That's, you know what I mean? Like that's my end game. So the last thing I want to do with parenting is like burden, because I feel like a lot of parents burden the kids with the business. Nah, we gonna hire a CEO and let that thing fun. It's a vehicle.
Yeah.
And it could feed you, your kid, and you could be off doing art in the south of France or some shit. Whatever your heart desire. You know what I'm saying?
I will. We're eating French toast.
You feel me?
I will.
You know?
With hash browns and shit.
It's freedom, man. I think that's all any of us really crave is freedom.
Right.
To just do what the fuck you want to do.
You just recently moved to Atlanta, right?
I did, man. Not even a month ago.
Right. And you said the way that it just moves down here. Talk about that for a minute.
So, you know, I'm from PG County, you know.
Word!
Yeah.
PG County. No, I'm just bullshit. Y'all be abbreviating that shit like everybody know what that means.
Man, but you know
I
what?
I do, but it's like tell
we
them.
Because maybe, I don't know, we think so much of ourselves that the world just know what this little
this
county
nigga said PG County.
Like you say PG and they just be like, oh, PG County, you know, I know where that's at.
My man's dead from out there.
But that's how it be though. Somebody got somebody from PG County. Yeah, I know them, they be up
there. You know who I know from out there.
You know what I'm saying? So like, it'd be like, oh, they from Baltimore, they from PG, that's what they gonna say.
Yeah.
So, you know.
One parent or two parents. That's basically what you said.
Yeah. Look, one on one, man.
Exactly.
You know? But it's a real black place and I love it. I love my upbringing. I love the culture, the town we came up in. You know, we had our own clothes, we had our own designs, we had our own slang, we had
Prince
our own
George
music,
County for the people.
You know, and this is, you know, through DC, just that area, Prince George's County, DC, that whole, you know, the DMV, I guess is what it goes by now. But just the culture that it was when I was coming up back in the late 90s, early 2000s, it was so authentic. You know what I mean? Like we didn't even wear none of the designer stuff. I mean, some people did, but you know, the majority of the area wore, you know, clothes and merchandise and everything from people that was produced. It was produced in that area. And then, of course, you had go-go and that, you know, upbringing and going back and forth to the clubs and everything. So it was a real, like, one-on-one kind of upbringing. But I started to realize it wasn't a place where you could really jump into anything else.
Right.
You know, like, you know, I mean, as of late basketball, of course, you know, you produce, you know, tons of basketball players. But outside of that and go-go and government jobs, I mean, it ain't, you know, you can't walk nowhere and walk on the set and do something that could potentially change your life in the middle of a week.
Right.
Nah, that's not that. But to answer your question, coming down here, I came down here with a project, a restaurant brand called Victory that's coming to Atlanta. And that's what we down here for, to start with that project. But already since being down here, I mean, we've connected and talked about other projects and, you know, stuff we talked about. And it's like the fact that I'm here after being here for what, 23 days, is proof to my point of it's really a land of opportunity.
Just see, I've been telling y'all and y'all thought I was just talking shit. As a black business owner, just moving to Atlanta changes the whole fucking everything.
Yeah.
Tell them, man. Let them know.
Don't take this shit for granted, man. Like it's once you realize what it is, you know, like, I guess step outside and say, okay, this is what's happening. In comparison to some of the areas, and like I said, I love, you know, where I grew up at. But we don't have the film industry. We don't have, you know, any of these other avenues where
that's
you
what
could.
Atlanta got everything. It's the film industry, it's the TV industry,
mm-hmm.
It's we got music, we got athletes, we got all types of shit here.
You
man.
See what I'm saying?
Yeah, man.
So,
you can fuck around in Atlanta and make a job.
You know?
No cap. I seen it happen.
Yeah, so it was a...
The Water Boys about to buy a water store.
Mm-hmm.
The Atlanta Water Boys.
Okay.
I just made that up. Stop clapping. See, it sounds real.
That shit.
It sounds real, doesn't it?
You said the Water Boys about to buy a water store. I said, what? I thought that was some Atlanta shit. All right, well, nah. Damn.
Where can they find you, man? Where can they reach you? Like, let them know some of the services that you offer.
So what we do is, my base is electrical.
Right.
But I'm self-taught in a lot of other areas, like security cameras, and I work with some guys with IT, and just my aim and my goal was, as an electrician, I felt like I should be able to do something with every wire in the building, right? Because that's what it is. Like, we come from in the building, you know, down to every outlet. And I just didn't see anything that resembled the service that I wanted to offer. You know, if it's an electrical company, they did electrical. Security camera company does security. You know, LED lighting does LED lighting. And I did all of this shit. So, you know, as I'm realizing and like we kind of sharpening it and seeing what we're presenting to people, it's an all-in-one kind of where when we do restaurants, like on build outs, I'm doing the lighting, I'm putting the TVs up, I'm doing the security cameras, you know, every HVAC control, you know, access control, the security, alarm system, fire, you know, tying off the fire alarm, every aspect of that building, we put it in the palm basically of your hand. So, like, say we had it in here right now, I could go in here, turn that TV on, turn those lights off, you know, turn some other lights on, lock the door right there.
Yeah, I need some shit like that.
You know, I mean, it's...
Turn the crib into a matrix.
Yeah. Hey, that's what we do, man. That's what we do. And it's the system that we use is different from, like, the... It's one thing I wanted to get out, like, the Amazon and, you know, all that stuff. I don't use, like... any of that stuff. We use a one-off system where they sell us the material. We design, plan, and program all of these systems using, you know, low voltage electrical control, different things that already exist and that are proven. We use that kind of stuff to automate a building. So if you all are in the studio from 2 p.m. to 7 p.m. Monday through Thursday, we can create that out, block it in the schedule, and your HVAC will be at the right temperature while you're recording. You can walk out of the building, the lights are shut off, the building are armed, the HVAC is shut down, all that until you come back the next morning.
Yeah, Kat, that's what we're getting, man.
Yeah.
Me and Kat already talked about it.
Yeah, so.
And then when I walk up, it's gonna be some lights that light up. Like Tony Stark, I'm gonna walk up, they're gonna be like, then the fucking the gate go up, right? It just know what time I'm
we
coming.
We can do that, man.
Hell yeah.
We can do that.
Yeah.
You know, so.
And then it's gonna be like a little part in the wall where I walk past, blunt roll out, grab the blunt, walk to the chair. The chair gonna be like already at the door, so when I sit in the chair, drive me over to this spot. Right in the camera. The camera going to adjust to my face, scan my facial features and shit. That's where we going with this shit. Our budget is $80 million.
Oh, shit. We can go all the way there.
No, I'm just bullshitting. That shit sound cool as fuck, bro. If you could just goddamn make it so all the shit work, we straight. We'll turn our own goddamn light off. It'd be cool if we could just lock that motherfucker from at the house, we'd be straight.
Yeah.
You gotta overthink this shit.
You know, And I'm gonna say one thing, and it might like a disagreement, but like what it comes to.
Let me start and shit now.
No.
Because you said it before you even, hey man, somebody gonna disagree.
Somebody gonna disagree with this shit because a lot of people make money off this shit, but I'm more so like a creative.
Okay,
I just
bet.
Happen to do like electrical. Like
okay,
if you
bet.
Think like a painter, my paintbrush is just these tools and these lights and shit.
Yeah.
Right? So with a lot of this home security and stuff and this shit that they sell people, they get people trapped in 5-year contracts. They paying, you know, all this crazy money for monitoring service and all this shit. Like somebody come in your fucking house and you home, you either gonna have to shoot them or, you know, they gonna run away. So why am I paying motherfuckers $75 a month to
just watch?
Hey, what's up? Karlous Miller here. And when it's cold outside, who are you holding? Well, fellas, look, I'm here to tell you. It's gonna be nobody if you don't get you some Blue Chew. Blue Chew is a unique online service that delivers the same active ingredients as Viagra and Cialis, but in chewable tablets and at a fraction of the cost. The first step is simple. Visit BlueChew.com, then consult with one of their licensed medical providers, and once you're approved, you'll receive your prescription within days. Blue Chew's tablets are made in the USA and prepare and ship direct to your door in a discreet package. So if you can benefit from extra confidence when it's time to perform, Blue Chew can help. And we've got a special deal for our listeners. Try Blue Chew for free when you use promo code BLACK at checkout. Just pay $5 shipping. That's BlueChew.com, promo code BLACK, B-L-A-C-K, to receive your first month free. Visit BlueChew.com for more details and important safety information, and we thank Blue Chew for sponsoring this podcast.
It ain't gonna get the police there no quicker, so, you know, when we design these buildings, these are one-off buildings. There's no monthly charge. You know, we can tap in and do, you know, maintenance and things like that, but the idea is you creating an energy-efficient, you know, building. Like,
right.
Everything is really no need for monitoring. So, I think you said the website?
Yeah.
The website is logixdesignbuild.com. my Instagram, I don't really have a business Instagram just because people get to send you DM. I can't do business that way, so.
Oh, okay.
I can't fuck with that shit.
You don't like money, plug it out.
Nah, you know.
A lot of money on there.
Yeah, you gotta set boundaries, though, like as a business owner, you know what I'm saying? Because people
DM. The business, bro, you can't be out here with integrity, man. If you want to make it in America, bro, one of your biggest jobs is going to be some Russians who are going to be like, listen, don't ask questions. Why are the fucking TVs and get the fuck out, you black motherfucker. You're going to be like, you know what? How much money you say in that case? All of it you take, we don't need. I'm just saying. You tell me, set the boundaries, man. I can't just be out here doing everything. Look, if you got roaches, a flat screen is the last thing.
You gonna go put a TV up with some roaches, and you walk into somebody's
house. You know how many niggas got flat screens up that's got a roach stuck between the wall and the TV mount?
Yeah. But if you was going to put TVs
not me
up,
personally, exactly. I have roach PTSD.
I can't fuck with it. I grew up with them motherfuckers.
Oh my God. You know? I don't like nothing.
Now your mother don't like you talking about women. My mother don't like you talking about that shit.
I don't like bugs because of roaches. They all roaches to me.
Say roach crawl out your cereal box. First thing in the morning, you still gotta eat the cereal. You know your mother not buying you
no
more.
The roach that always worried me was the one that was just out. Like, where you been? He was going to fuck up some of the family shit.
Where they going, man?
And you know, as a kid, you really thought that you could just kill all of them? It's fucking impossible.
Motherfuckers fuck like nothing else.
You know what they say, nigga? By the time you start seeing them, it's already millions of them.
That's their house.
You literally.
You just lit it.
You just gotta move. Don't take none of your stuff.
Yeah.
It don't matter what you take, they going, hey, you thought that was it?
Fuck roaches, man.
Fuck them. I think roaches was like, I think the government put roaches in the project.
Hood.
I
know
that's the biggest conspiracy, bro. Roaches were put in the hood, bro.
Because you don't see roaches other places.
Nowhere else.
But in a fucking hood, white people don't, you don't ever hear no white person talk about, man, when you was growing up with rats and roaches.
Roach, I'm telling you, bro, that shit real.
They made them motherfuckers.
I'm not saying they made them, but they put them there.
What the fuck,
because think about, like, the roaches that you saw in the project. Mm-hmm. You don't see them. Them not roaches you would see anywhere else. Them are just, like, project roaches.
They adapted to their environment. They like little niggas, but they roaches. They not like regular roaches.
They not.
Not suburban roaches. Them bruh, the big ass.
These motherfuckers, they had, you ever tried to call the exterminator on some roaches? After that first trip, it's like the roaches know you called them.
Mm-hmm.
Cause you know, they be like, we gotta come back and do some treatments.
It's not their first go run.
Exactly. And then it's like, you see all these drugged up roaches, they're like, yo, trying to kill us?
Hey, when I move down here, what's them big ass bugs y'all got down here?
Yeah, so y'all. I don't own any bugs, sir.
You ain't never seen these bugs?
Brother, big ass, like, water bugs and shit.
Yeah, they look like big ass roaches.
Them bitches fast as fuck.
Nigga. We got in the house like, what the fuck?
See, these are literally outside roaches. So sometimes they just get in the house. Don't be having people think you're going to move into a house and Georgia got these big, they outside roaches.
Them motherfuckers is industrial roaches.
And you can hear them when they're crawling. Ain't that shit crazy?
All that.
It'd be like, like it's Bigfoot ass roach.
I had to get used to that shit, man.
I can't
get used to it. We call the exterminator immediately.
Yeah, I call the exterminator. And like if I buy some shit or move to some shit, I'm calling them anyway. I don't give a fuck if I see something. I don't know who lived there.
Yeah, they had anything on.
Kill the spirits in this motherfucker.
Yeah, for sure.
Anyway, but look, bro, welcome to the black market. It's gonna be a lot of people. It's gonna be proud to see what you out here doing, man. I wish we could like show them some shit, but they don't need to see everything.
Yeah, you know, you'll be able to see it in the city, man. We looking at, I think, a mid-November, maybe late November open date for the restaurant that we doing here, Victory Restaurant.
So when they in Victory, that's all your work?
No.
Most of it?
No.
Some of it? Three-fourths?
I break you down to what's...
75%? 25%?
No, Victory is none of mine.
Oh,
Victory is one of my partners, Cotto, that has one in Miami, one in D.C., I actually did the lighting and everything in the one in D.C.
Okay.
And then we're doing the one here in Victory. And I work with an interior designer. Her name is LaToya.
Shout out to LaToya.
Yeah, shout out to
all black girls named LaToya. And LaTanya's too. Most definitely LaTasha's.
Yeah.
Gotta say what's up to all the live.
You know, so her company, you know, Invigor Design Group. So she basically tied me in a lot of what she was doing.
Bet.
You know, it's taking off. I mean, when we first met, we both had like struggling businesses. You know, we was really just kind of touching out. And then she called me one day, basically like, hey, it's on. And ever since then, I think in the last 2 years, we've probably done, what, 3 restaurants, 2 smoke shops, including a restaurant in, what, Jacksonville, a couple in D.C., a couple of whole house, small house.
Whole houses?
Yeah. No, we do it all, man.
Whole house?
Whole houses.
Oh, whole houses.
I
thought you said like whole houses.
If it was a whole house that needed the services.
A whole house.
I mean, would you do a whole house?
Like a whole house
party?
If
it ain't had no roaches.
Right.
You would do a whole house. You put some lights in the whole house.
Oh, yeah. Hell yeah. You got to be able to see it now.
I would, because I'm married.
I wouldn't. I'd just be in there trying to make sure the lights was good. I'd be in there strictly professional.
Yeah, 100%.
LEDs.
Tie a sweatshirt around.
Yeah. Black light.
Yeah.
So you can see where you stepping.
Karlous Miller here. It's holiday season, and you know what that means. Online purchases are about to be at an all-time high. With ShipStation, the hassle of shipping out holiday orders melts away, leaving you with happier customers and more freedom to run your business and enjoy some much-needed time off. With ShipStation, not only do you save money, but it's also extremely easy to set up thanks to their user-friendly software. No wonder 98% of companies that use ShipStation for a year keep them for as long as they're in business. It's that good. We have a special offer for our listeners. Use offer code EXCELLENCE to get a 60-day free trial. Just enough time to handle the holiday rush. Just go to ShipStation.com, click on the microphone at the top, and enter the code EXCELLENCE. ShipStation.com, make ship happen.
I don't think you want to turn that black light on in that whole house. You want to turn that black light on.
Oh, really?
Oh, shit, man.
Well, look, don't let this be your last time stopping through the black market. Let them know where they can find you at one more time, G.
So the website is Logix Design Build. Instagram is Jamil Hassan, J-A-M-E-E-L-H-A-S-S-A-N
Jamil Hassan.
S-S-A-N underscore. On Twitter and Instagram. I'm not really doing a lot of business stuff there, so I wouldn't come there looking for that, but the business stuff is on the website. So
yeah, shout out to your son for holding it down, man.
For sure, man. It was just trying to be an example, man. So I hope, you know, if anybody else see that, a lot of thing we ain't get to talk about, a lot of people in trades, you know, it's a lot of us in trades, and it's a labor shortage right now.
Is it?
Across the country, man.
Why you ain't tell me about this? You holding out information.
I had so much shit to get off my head.
Did you get it off?
I mean, nah, I didn't want to, you know.
Oh, you should have said something, man. I'm not holding you back.
Look, it's a labor shortage nationwide, and what's happening is a lot of the older people in the trades are retiring, and it's not a lot of younger people there to fill those roles.
You know why?
Yeah.
Because those older guys went home complaining every day and made everybody hate their job. Now don't nobody want it.
Yeah, it's not. It's one of them things, you gotta take the attitude, like, you gotta have to do that shit. You know the niggas that make it in football and basketball and all that, it's because they coming from some shit that they gotta get out of.
Right.
Like, that's what the type of focus that you need. So, when I was going through the electrical trade, man, I'm working on structures 150 feet up in the air, you know, like, all kind of shit, raining, Tuesday morning.
See, that's the type of, that shit, they don't make people like that no more.
Yeah, nah, niggas is in the house. And I'm not mad at them. But some of these niggas that ain't got no job need to get some tools and get in these fucking trades, because you can make $100,000 across the board as a plumber, as an electrician, as an HVAC tech. It's the next step right into entrepreneurship. You know, you can have something similar to what we're doing right now, put your own creative touch on it, and you can build a vehicle that could provide, you know, shit like trash companies. Trash companies don't go out of business. Why?
Ever.
Ain't no, because it's trash every motherfucking day.
Right.
Electricians ain't gonna go out of business. Why? Because you can't do shit. You know, you be in the dark. So these are the trades that I feel like built the country, and we got an opportunity to, especially with automation and a lot of the shit that's going on in electrical, and I stick to electrical because that's gonna be the driving force of, I think, what we evolve into with smart buildings and smart cities and all this other jetson shit we used to watch, you know, growing up and shit. But you can take that and you can buy yourself a piece of a multi-billion dollar industry, you know, and how you get in is up to you. You can go to a college and take courses and get in on the engineering side. Damn, that shit was crazy, wasn't it? Get in on the engineering side, you could go to a trade school. You can go to a vocational school and just get a little bit and try to get the rest in the field. But however you get it, it's opportunities. You know, felonies ain't stopping it. You know,
that
it's
don't
really
mean
no
go
excuse.
Get no felonies either.
No, don't go get no felonies. But I mean, get out there and work. Like, it's not for, you know, it's hard work. Like, being on the site at 6 a.m., working 6 to 2, you might have to drive an hour to work. All that shit is hard. No, I'm not going to lie to you, like, this shit is a cake. But for some people that's looking and that's needing to provide for their families, like, get your ass out there and work. That's what you do. When you fucked up, like I fucked up, you know, just growing up and kind of blowing opportunities to do, all right, now you got to put the shit on your back. You got to do some shit that make you uncomfortable, you know. But if you could take that and then turn it into something else, kind of like what we was able to do with this, you know, now I don't know nobody else that do what I do.
Right.
And I tried to find it. Like, it's no, you know, path. So I just think it's so much opportunity in this shit, man. And it's people in the trades, but it's a lot of people that's out there, you know, outside not doing shit that could benefit from, you know, going into an apprenticeship or taking on some art work or, you know, any of these other opportunities that's out, that exist in the field. So that's a message I want to spread outside of entrepreneurship. If you're not running a business, at least get in there and get your hands dirty.
Get a skill.
And make some money.
Yeah, get you a skill, get a trade. Then take your trade and do it by yourself. Now you on.
Now you on.
Black Business 106. That's gonna be in the summer course for everybody who gonna have to go to summer school anyway. Did you know that this was voted the number one black show amongst black people who live in a house with more than two people?
This one right here. Something to be proud of, man.
I know, man. It's breaking records every week.
Not a lot of houses with two black people.
No, I know. We just started getting heavy rotation on the night shift at all the nursing homes. Did you know that? All across the country. All the hospitals and people who work overnight, this is their number one show.
You know why I fuck with that? Because, like, you can come here and it ain't none of that PC shit.
You don't have to be PC. This the black market, bro. Everybody who come on this show work for themselves.
You feel me?
Yeah. And then our whole goal is to push people who are just standing right there, just too scared to make that fucking first step.
Just commit, man. And it's you can do it the right way.
Right. Right?
Like, you can save your money before you leave your job. That's not what I did.
Right.
You know, I jumped the fuck out there. I ain't had no savings. I just had clients, and I knew I could work. I worked my ass off. So that was my story. That's not gonna be everybody else's, and I wouldn't advise it because the shit is hard as a motherfucker. But, you know, just take that fucking stuff with you. All you got to do other than that is just die. You gonna die anyway, whether you do it or not.
Damn, bro.
That's what I put everything.
Damn.
It sound crazy, right?
Damn.
It sound crazy.
It don't sound crazy, but I was gonna follow up with, it's like you said, it's not necessarily about oh, I gotta quit my job so I can start this business. Man, you need to hustle where you comfortable at.
Yeah.
Like if it take you starting your job, you might have to just stop sleeping so much, man. Get your ass up. Mm-hmm. Put the same effort into your shit like you doing they shit.
That's it. That's where it starts. But you gotta be a good employee to be a good boss.
Exactly.
Some point.
You don't even understand what an employee is because you ain't never been the boss yet.
Mm-hmm.
It's crazy.
Yeah, it's a lot that's tied into entrepreneurship, man. It'll burn you out. It'll have you fucking wanting to quit, second guessing the shit. You know, and it's a survival.
Then you start making some money.
And that money start coming in.
Oh my God, it's way better. I'm talking about you can be struggling for 5 years straight, mm-hmm. but as soon as you start making a profit, it could just be $1. That shit changed the whole landscape. It's just like gas, see? Like, shit, I just made, what? Man, mm-hmm. let me take, all right, now we rolling.
Mm-hmm. No, I used to mix the Kool-Aid with the sugar packs?
Yeah.
I used to sell them motherfuckers at elementary school. Like, it's always, like, been about everything from DVDs to oils to, you know what I'm saying? It's always there, like, it's always a dollar to be made, you know,
exactly.
if you're willing to apply yourself to something. And you might go through 20 things. I done did a bunch of shit. I done rap. I done threw parties, I done, you know what I'm saying, like all kind of shit down to the electrical work. But what you realize in moving through that and moving through this journey is you kind of build yourself up to get to that next level. So when you hit your shit, like I wasn't never supposed to be here no other time than right now.
Yeah.
Because if I had seen this shit 10 years ago, you might have seen a fucking 20-some-year-old, 15 years ago, a 20-some-year-old rapper that was, you know, wild as shit, you know, with a guy
dead the fuck serious,
bitch, drunk at the parties, you know what I'm saying? All the, like, it wasn't that time, but if you keep hitting that motherfucker and refining and refining and refining, I think you come up with some amazing shit, and then next thing you know, like, you know, people fucking with you, and boom.
So many people be overthinking this shit. It's right there in front of you.
Mm-hmm.
I tell people all the time, man, God gave us, he gave everybody at least one talent.
Yeah.
And your gift is to find out what it is, man. The one thing you can do better than anybody that you was gonna do anyway, that's where the money at.
For sure.
And that's where the peace is, because it's something that you don't mind doing. It doesn't bother you to do this.
Yeah.
Whether you're getting paid or...
That's the biggest part of the journey.
Yeah.
You know, like finding that thing that, like I tell my son when he was growing up, like, find that shit that's gonna keep you up at night. Like, if you ain't have to pay for food or car, gas, all that shit was paid for, but you just had to do something.
Right.
You know, what would that thing be? And make it easy, like you was just saying, make it easy on yourself by just looking inside of yourself to see, like, all right, what the fuck am I good at? Like, right. I was good at a lot, and it's a curse. It's a gift and a curse. Because I could rap and I could do all this other shit good, but I'm great at this shit. You right. feel me? Like, when I look at a building,
but
I look
at I'm saying, like, no effort. This shit don't even...
The building just stand up on the page. I'm, like, on some Iron Man shit in my mind.
Yeah.
And to deny that... Like, so I want to be on the real estate investing side, flip a couple houses, you know what I'm saying? Do all, but this shit, man, I don't think nobody could do this shit like I can. So
yeah.
Why would I deny myself that?
See? That's you the know? Appeal of it. That shit... Everything look easy because you think you could do it, nigga. That shit ain't no TV show. You don't just finish, you don't put paint a house in that bitch for somebody to show up with the money.
We'll take it.
What about them motherfuckers? You still flipped them, but it took 7 months to flip that motherfucker.
And see, I know the real estate investors I work with, like, are professional, you know. I mean, you have to be a professional real estate investor, you
right.
know. And it's everybody, like, saw, I think, real estate investing come up and was like, oh, you know, this is sexy.
That. Nah,
like,
fuck
I can
that.
Do that, you know.
Don't overlook the work part of it.
And that was me, though, in the beginning, like, 100%, like, being real. In the beginning, I was looking at it from just a pure money standpoint, money in, money out. And at the time, I wasn't doing full houses as a contractor.
Right.
So even though I knew, you know, commercial and industrial and all that, you know, from the union, once I started seeing the process in the house, and oh, you can do all this shit, but your grass graded the wrong way or some shit, or the land
fence
graded
too
the
high.
Wrong. Yeah, the fence too.
You gotta take the fence down. The fence was up when you bought the house, though.
And that shit started looking real unsexy.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That real estate investment shit started looking real unsexy.
No, because
so.
I bought a property, and the motherfucker I bought it from was just building shit wherever they wanted to. Did you know that this is over the property line? I was like, did you know that I will cut all of that shit down? Did you know that they sold me that like that? Well, it's up to you.
Man, it's a lot to go into that shit, man. Amen. I respect the shit out of real estate investors. I be trying to get out the field. So like what we able to do with this, designing and programming, manufacturing the panel and everything offsite from the house, shipping it to the site. If you got a qualified electrician on the site, they'll be able to install it per plan. And I don't never have to leave the house. Like that's my end game. Cause you can only make so much in the field. You know what I mean? You can't do, you know, if I get a 30,000 square foot warehouse, me and my son can't do that.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like it's gonna need.
You need some more sun.
You know, 20 of us. You know what I'm saying? Like, and that's the goal. You know, to work yourself to where you can't do it on your own, and then you know, bring in the right people to help you along, man.
Well, look, G, you definitely got the right mind state, man. And I appreciate you stopping through the black market and fucking with us and
sure.
Dropping game. And we wish you much success. And don't let this be the last time, bro.
Oh, man, of course.
Welcome to the city, man.
Appreciate it, man.